हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोना डिस्कस विद यू अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ कोड फोर्सेस डिवीजन 672, सॉरी राउंड 672 डिवीजन 2, एंड द प्रॉब्लम नेम इज रॉक इन द लिवर. सो व्हाट वी हैव गिवन इन दिस प्रॉब्लम इज वी हैव एन पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स एंड वी हैव टू बेसिकली कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ पेयर्स सच दैट देयर एंड इफ वी कैलकुलेट द एंड ऑफ दीज टू इंटीजर्स इट शुड बी आइदर ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू दैट देयर और सॉरी एक्सऑर. ओके, so let's say we have some bunch of integers. So basically we have to calculate all the pairs having integers, let's say ai and aj, such that ai and aj should be greater than equal to ai xor aj. So as we all know, in an operator if we have a bit 1 and 1, then only our bit is gonna become 1. Otherwise, in all other scenarios like 10 or 01 or 00, it would be 0. And in case of XOR, if we have a bit 1, if we take it XOR with 0, then in this particular scenario, our bit would be 1. And similarly, in case of 01, it would be 1. And all other scenarios like 11 or 00, it would be 0. So basically our aim is to calculate the number of pair those having this particular condition fulfilled, this condition. So the way we can think about this is, to make this particular value greater, we have to consider the value of ai and aj such that their most significant bit is the, if we consider from the left, the last bit from the left, basically the first bit from the right, which is set. Okay, in this particular case, this particular bit is the most significant bit. Similarly, in this scenario, this is the most significant bit, basically the first bit from the right inside and the last bit, set bit, from the left inside. Okay, that would be our most significant bit. So this particular condition, which is end of those integer would be greater than that of XOR, will be satisfied in only scenario when the most significant bit of these the two integer would be at the same position, and it should be 1, because in this particular scenario only this would result in a 1, and we don't even care about all the remaining integers, because if this particular bit would be 1, the sum which would be given by this, basically the sum contribution by this bit would be 2 to power i, and if all other bit would be either equal to 1, the contribution by all other bit would be 2 to power i minus 1. So basically we have to take care about the most significant bit only, and if it would be 1 in both the element, in that particular scenario our AND operator will be either equal to, not equal to, it's definitely gonna greater than that of XOR of those two integers. So now I'll take you through my code, what I am doing in this problem. So I am here taking n, the number of element which we gonna take. Here what I am doing, here I am taking all the elements out there. I am basically going from the last bit, 30th bit, to the first bit, basically 0th bit. Okay, from the right I am coming to the left, and whenever I see the most significant bit of the particular element to be 1, I'll just counting that element and making that element equal to minus 1, so that I won't consider that element for another case. And so the way, let's say we have a bunch of integers who have their ith bit 1, okay. So the number of ways would be basically choose out of these n elements. So nc2 would be the number of total number of pairs which we had to consider in that particular scenario. And as we all know, n into n plus I n minus 1 divided by 2 is the value which we consider for this. So basically this is what I'm doing right here, and that's how I'm reporting my answer. So I'll put the link to my source code in the description. You can check it out if you need it. थैंक यू, प्लीज़ डू लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल।